Hello friends, welcome back. So in this embedded C programming quiz tutorials and playlist, there is something that is very important which I did not cover. How do we identify segmentation faults or core dumps? Do we have examples for it? All these are to be covered, and it is a very important topic which carries a lot of attention even in the interviews. So I thought I should make it a separate video, and that's what I'm going to do right now. This session would talk about the segmentation fault and core dump. Many a times we really hate it and we do not know what to do, and most of the times I have seen children and even myself during my learning days, when I get core dump, I do not know what to do. This session will give you a quick overview of what is it and how do we avoid it, and some simple examples where I got I purposefully generated core dumps and segmentation fault so that you can understand that you should not do it when you are writing the code. So let's define it first. As usual, I need to go with definition. This occurs fundamentally because of memory access violation. Means you are doing something wrong with the memory, or you are accessing memory location which really do not belong to you. If you are accessing the area which doesn't belong to you, it is an error, it is a violation. If you want to go and sit in the neighbor's house without his permission, that's not right. That area is not yours. That's exactly what is segmentation fault. You are trying to access a memory location which doesn't belong to you. And in that case, it will throw an error, and that is called a segmentation fault or core dump. I will classify which is segmentation fault and why do we call it as core dump, and these things will be done shortly. Now, when do we get the segmentation faults or the core dump? Simple. You try to write into the read-only memory location. There are some read-only memory locations. I'll show you a simple example. If you try to write there, it's a problem. It will throw a code dump. You try to access the freed, I mean the previously used but released memory location. That will create a problem. Stack overflow. That creates a major impact. Improper usage of scanf. I'm going to show you an example. That will actually do a nasty stuff inside, and it is going to hang the system, and that will be an improper exit. That's what we are going to get right now. So the core dump shall indicate that you are at fault and it is an error. Let's see how do we get this error, and you guys should not do it is the point. This is a learning where we need to follow this as a coding guideline and appropriately code in our project so that we will not get this core dump. First, we need to understand the difference between the core dump and segmentation fault. Let me start with core dump. A core dump is a file that usually is returned when an application crashes. After a segmentation fault, the application will crash and that will be returned as a core dump file. So this will be helpful for the developer to analyze the state of the application at the time of crash. It is like a black box. This is a core dump file. This is a file. Remember, core dump is just not an error. It is a file that will get generated, and you can analyze it later on to see where and how exactly the error has occurred. And this is the best point about it. Now, segmentation faults are nothing but are the results of invalid memory access. And when you come to Linux, I can prove you this, and can cause a SIGINT signal. SIGINT is nothing but SIG interrupt. That can usually cause the application to terminate. So as a result of improper memory access, your application will terminate, and as the result of it, you will get the core dump file generated. So now you understand the difference between core dump and segmentation fault, right? I hope this is very easy and important. Now, what do? We are going to go for a first example where I'm going to try modifying a string. Now, you can see that I have got a character star s equal to Sachin Tendulkar is the greatest of all batsmen. Now, star s equal to h, I'm trying to write something into the string. So this is a read-only memory as of now, and I'm trying to access it. Now what will happen? You'll get a core dump. So segmentation fault has come and the core dumped. So you are not permitted to write the read-only memory. Next one, scanf usage. Improper usage of scanf leads to, again, an improper exit. It will be a termination of the program. Well, this is because of memory access again. So we use scanf this way, scanf percentage C or percentage D, comma, at, I mean ampersand, some variable name, CH, A, B, C, D, something like that. So this should be an address. Now what do I do here? Int main, int P equal to 10, scanf percentage D. Here, instead of using ampersand, I leave it as the variable name itself. This is a bug. And what will happen is, this will get hanged. You can see that my cursor is hanging here, it will keep hanging for a bit of time and then it will terminate abnormally, and this is also because of improper memory access. Out of array example, this is a very interesting example. Now see that I've got an array with a limit of 10 elements in the array, but I'm trying to assign a value into 11th element. So what will happen? You are trying to access a memory location which doesn't belong to you. So what will happen? Obvious. It will say that stack smashing detected, termination will happen and code dumped. This will be aborted because you do not have any right to access memory location which is never in your control. So the next one is going to be very easy and important. Stack overflow. What is it? Very simple. I have a main void inside that I call main. What do we call it as? We call it as recursion. And this is absolutely fine and legal actually. But this will throw an error because it will keep looping and looping and looping, and this will never end. So segmentation fault will happen. This is not a wrong code, but this is a bad code. The difference is this is a real bad code. Now, we've got the segmentation fault error here. Now understand, always, this is a very important question when it comes to embedded systems or embedded C programming. What is segmentation fault? How do we get it? How can we avoid it? All these are kind of coding guidelines. I request you to go through it once again if you do not understand it. I hope I have made it clear in this small session. If you have any queries, suggestions, inputs, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be happy to answer them all. Thank you.